Switch and case are kind of specialized versions of if statements. So like, say I'm asking for puppies again, so I can't spell beautiful. How many puppies? So I can ask how many puppies, and now I could say if x is equal to 1, I could say, okay, you need 3 more puppies. And then I could say else if x is equal to 2, I could say you have a perfect pair of puppies. And I could say else if x is equal to 3, I could display you have a trio of puppies. Okay, spell puppies. Puppies, 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 puppies. You have 2 squared puppies. All right, so I can keep going, right? And I've got all these stupid else if statements. Seriously. And then otherwise, lots of puppies. Right. So I could have this really obnoxious if statement. And instead of having an obnoxious if statement, let's have an obnoxious case statement. So 9 puppies, lots of puppies. So basically the idea is instead of doing this else if, else if, else if, else if, else if, else if, else if thing, what I could do is something called a case switch. So I'm going to use almost the exact same looking logic, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch on the value of x. So basically what that means is I'm going to look at x and see how it changes. And I can say in case 1, I can display this. So in case 1, I'm going to say this. So basically all of these else ifs, I'm going to switch with case 2 and case 3 and case 4. And case 5, and then saying else, I'm going to say otherwise. I think, yeah, turn blue, lots of puppies. So what I can do here is I can actually set this up. And I guess the idea is this is just a whole lot easier to look at because I can see there's these 5 different cases. And I'm not having to look at all these different ifs and else ifs and else ifs and else ifs. And because it all depends just on one value, because it's not like, well, if x is this and y is this, or if this is this and this is this, it's like all these weird things at once. Switch and case statements are very, very straightforward for just the most basic of comparisons, and they work really, really well with integers, and I'm sure there's other ways to make them work, but for me, I've always just liked using them for things that are just like integer values, like this. So I can say how many puppies, and if there's 5, I should have started with the CLC clear. This actually works the exact same way. So you might be, why are we doing this? And I'm like, I don't know, because we're programming and you always need to know how to do stuff. And lots of puppies. And so the basic format of this is I'm going to switch on the value of x, and then I'm going to look at the different cases, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then otherwise. Okay? So actually, with switching case, it's pretty common to use, instead of an input statement, to use a menu. So this still works, and this is beautiful, and this is amazing. Lots of puppies. But what I can do is I can replace this with something called a menu statement, and I can say how many puppies. And I'm going to say you've got 1, 2, 3, and you're like, what are you doing? And like, I'll show you in a minute. Stop asking questions. Or 5. Okay. So I can run this, and now it's actually going to come up with a little question box. How many puppies? And then my options are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And it's perfect because that's the order I put them in. So whenever I click 1, it comes back with 1 puppy, and 3, and then comes back with 3 puppies, and you're like, oh, okay, that makes sense. So I have this little menu. The first thing that's in the menu is the question. So if I changed it to how many dodo birds, how do you spell dodo birds? I don't know, now it says how many dodo birds. It's like I control the universe. How many puppies? 4. Okay, now here's where it's going to be weird. I want any more puppies. No! Stop it, puppies. Okay. I could say, what if I decide I'm going to change this value to 99? So I'm going to say, do I have 1, 2, 99, 4, or 5? I'm going to say, I have 99 puppies. And it still says I have a trio of puppies. And you're like, but I said I have 99, and it's showing it like x is 3. And you're like, there must be something wrong with my code. So I'm going to not suppress this. And it's going to come back, and I say 99 puppies. And it says x equals 3. And you're like, But that can't be the case because I clearly said I have 99 puppies. And this is because this is how menu works. The way that menu works is actually going to come and it's going to look at these buttons in order. So if I've done 1, 2, and 3, this is actually the third button. And so X comes back as being equal to 3. So if I select the third button, it's going to come back as 3. X will have a value of 3. And it'll say I have a trio of puppies. You may have noticed whenever I hit the X and I X'd out of this, that X came back as 0, and then that said lots of puppies. So there actually is a sixth option. So right now I have 5 buttons, but I could always click this button and get out of it. Whenever you click the little X, it comes back as 0. So I can say case 0. How come you don't like my question? So we're going to make them feel guilty for not answering my question. So now if I X out of this, it's going to say, how come you don't like my question? Because it returns a 0 whenever you have a menu statement. So I'm going to say 4, and that's going to come back as 4. But whenever I click 99, that's the third button. So that's always important to remember, is MATLAB doesn't actually care what is in the button text. So the 3 is just button text. Yeah, it's just button text, so it doesn't do anything, which means that you can do all kinds of other things with it. So see about, you know, we could say, like, what's your favorite color? So come up with something where you ask the user for their favorite color and then judge them based on that. Because if you can't judge random people who play with your computer game, who can you judge? So see if you can do that. So like come up with something where you ask them for their favorite color and then be like, because you like red, that means that you are clearly a big coffee drinker or something. So think about ways that you could set that up. So actually pause the video, go see if you can set up a switch case statement combined with the menu, because that's how you're gonna see them a lot, like that. So we're gonna pretend that happened. Doop-de-doop-de-doo. So we're gonna start out with a menu, and you could say their favorite color is going to be given by menu. So you always start with menu, and you say, what's your favorite color? Now, you're gonna put a comma, and then you can put all the different answers. So I'm gonna say yellow, and red, and magenta, and there's gotta be other colors out there. Blue, and that's all the colors I care about. So red, notice that that's going to return a 2, and yellow is going to return a 1, and magenta is going to return a 3, and blue is going to return a 4, and if I exit out of it, it's going to return a 0. This means I didn't. So hopefully you're kind of getting the swing of what those things mean. Okay, so favorite color. Now, you have to make sure that you get it, so kind of think through it. I'm going to switch on the value of favorite color. So I'm going to switch on the value of favorite color. There are, in my case, 5 cases because there's 4 options and then there's the 0. So in the case 0, I can yell at them, you didn't pick 1. Okay. In case 1, they like yellow, so you must like mac and cheese because it's yellow. And then in case 2, now we cannot obviously do a lot more with these than just display statements, but this is just, you know, learning stuff. So if you like red, I think we said you like coffee. And if you picked magenta, I could say you're going to trip on your toes today. And in case 4, when you pick blue, I can say you are a toad frog. I don't know why face had to go in there. All right, now I can say otherwise. There shouldn't be an otherwise because you really should only have those 4 options. I can say I have no idea how you broke my code. And I just don't think that it's possible that it could not be 0, 1, 2, 3, or 5. Make sure that you end your code, because if you don't end it, if you take the switch, if you take the end off the switch, it's gonna turn red and be angry at you. Red, angry. And it underlines the switch to let you know what's going on. So it's pretty common for people to forget to end things. So So now I'm going to run this and I'm going to have red and it's going to say I like coffee. So I don't think that it can get out of answering or responding to me. And that's one of the nice things about a menu box. Whereas if I was actually asking a user to type in yellow, then I'd have to take into consideration that they would misspell yellow or misspell red or, you know, not capitalize it or capitalize it. And so one of the nice things about having a menu is if you know you're only going to have a set number of options that they can select from, it really does help you make your code prettier.